We're here at the Ice Cave Trading Post. It's a log cabin building. It was originally built to be a saloon in the 1930s. They had a saloon here and a dance hall. They built the saloon here because they could mine ice out of the ice cave, and that made it great to offer ice cold beer and year-round, especially in the summertime. There's about 19 volcanoes in this area, what they call El Malpais. This volcano is the second most recent eruption, and the most recent eruption is about 2,000 years ago. This volcano erupted around 10,000 years ago. It started forming as a swell in the earth, and then pressure started building. It cracked open and started spraying lava out of the fountain, a big tall fountain of lava. It was a mist of lava that hardened in midair and fell back down to the earth in a cone formation, kind of like an anthill. And at one point, the opening got large enough, and it started filling the cone up with lava, and then it washed out one side and started pouring down in the valley below. From the outside elevation to the rim is about 500 feet, and from the rim down to the bottom is 800 feet. Right on the edge of a large sinkhole, this is part of the main lava tube structure that poured out of the volcano. In sections of the lava tube, shortly after the lava cooled off, it fractured, and a lot of the lava tube collapsed. And so what you see here is a sinkhole. And this shows you the good idea of not only the width of the lava tube, but also the depth and the thickness of the lava. The lava at this point is at least 75 feet, maybe up to 100 feet thick. What we have here is we're located in a section of collapsed lava tube in one end where there's a cave, and just the right physical factors have combined to create a natural ice box. It's a natural phenomenon. The lava is very porous. It acts as a good insulating material. It not only insulates the heat from the outside in the summertime, but also the earth's heat from below. You also have to have a cave that'll trap water in the first place, and most of these lava structures are very fractured and let water drain out. So this cave started gathering water, freezing, and at one point it created a critical mass of ice, and that started a perpetual freeze. So ice has been forming for at least 3,400 years. This cave, as far as caves go, is just a little baby infant cave, 10,000 years. In geologic terms, that's just like yesterday. It's a very culturally significant ice cave. People have been interacting with this cave for over 1,200 years. Artifacts were discovered in and around this cave and several other caves in the area. They range in date from 800 to 1,200 years. So late era Anasazi, early Pueblo period people came down to the cave on a regular basis. The same pathway that gets you here to the ice cave from the edge of the lava flow is the same pathway people have been following for 1,200 years. And for the last 50 years, they've been coming down just to get a few moments of solitude in this quiet, beautiful little cool place, especially in the summertime. It'd be 95 degrees outside, and right here it's 30 degrees. It's a nice cool place to relax and gather your thoughts.